Hey guys, it's Worker Perez, and welcome to my here review for the premiere of My Little Pony Season 7. You're probably wondering, why is Batman on the screen? Well, my webcam is not working, which is why this is being uploaded several days late. And I asked my DeviantArt, my fellow bronies on there, what game they would like to see me review, play while I review the game, and the majority he picked Batman, so I'm playing Arkham Knight. And if I can quickly show you, this account is actually the pony themed, as you can see. So, it's quite fitting. But since it is on this account, I had to start the game from scratch. That's why it looks like it's the start of the game. Because it is. So, while Batman is flying through the air on his way to GCPD, let's talk about Season 1 and 2. Episode 1 and 2. So, what did I think of episode 1 and 2? You will notice I didn't put premiere, I specifically put 1 and 2 because these aren't, you know, regular 2-parters. They're just. And yeah, I'll be talking over the game.
Gotta go. Stay safe, Barbara.
They're more of two episodes, but they are kind of linked together. It reminds me a lot of the,
I'm just glad my little girl got out.
Episode. Now the real. Based on the Equestria games. And.
We were tracking an unknown military vehicle.
Just for psychics. If you guys remember that. Those episodes. They were like two different.
I just don't have the manpower.
Parts, but they were like. Linked together, which is why I get the feeling from these episodes.
Do you really think
so that's why I put down as episode 1-2 review.
I won't let that happen, Jim.
Ooh, and not season 7 premiere review.
It's going to be a long night.
Anywho, missing patrol car. Let's talk about the season.
Batman.
In 7 per.
Every damn time.
First two episodes, let's start with episode 1, and right off the bat, we get. I don't know if it technically counts as the Celestia episode everyone has been calling for, but, you know, it's a good sign that they will do one in the future, because if. Because Celestia was definitely the best. This character in episode 1. I don't know if anyone else feels that way, but that's how I viewed it. That was my understanding of the situation. To say the very least. Having her and Twilight interact more so than they have in past episodes. You know, they've had kind of interactions here and kind of interactions there. Like, the most they've interacted is probably the season 3 finale where Twilight became an alicorn. That was probably the most they've. Maybe you could say the season. Two premiere and finale are also in that category, but I definitely think this is by far Celestia's best outing. She really showed her.
I thought they were gonna kill me.
Top ability and showed. Why she can be
in the city's overrun.
A good character if given the chance. And I think this definitely allows the opportunity. This definitely shows that if they actually want to, the showrunners can indeed write an episode that will show Celeste in the light that people want to see her. You know, people want to find out more about her backstory. Find out more about her and Luna. We've learned a bit about Luna through her episode, but Celestia hasn't gotten that. Gotten that right. So, you know, it'll be good to see that.
Call off your men, Jim.
Go Oscar 5-6. This is Commissioner Gordon. I'm calling off the pursuit. It's too dangerous.
Sir, we're right here. We can take these bastards. What the? They just fired an RPG at us. Who the hell are these guys?
And, this is definitely by far Celestia's best episode.
5-6 is taking a direct hit from an RPG.
Well, where she has a prominent role. Now, she doesn't really have any prominent role in the game.
Don't worry, Jim. He's mine.
You know, the best up until this point is probably the first part of the Camelot Way. But other than that, she's been pretty much useless.
That takes care of the vehicle. I need to interrogate the driver and find out what he knows.
Quick, charge! Stay back! You lay a finger on me! I'll kill you!
Yeah, this was a nice change of pace. To see Celestia in a much better role. Not just be pretty much a useless character who only serves to get herself kidnapped and having to main six, or in last season's case, Starlight, save her ass. And it really said a lot about...
Where's Scarecrow?
Go to hell.
Much better. When we see Celestia in a much better role. So.
Where is he?
I got nothing.
As someone who, like many people, wants to see Celestia get her own episode, you know, where.
She's working out of a penthouse in Chinatown. I swear that's all I know!
Fills us in on her backstory. I definitely think. I think this would be a very good. This is a good sign that that episode could is more of a possibility than it has ever has been uploaded in the past.
Is this
Scarecrow's new toxin?
But yeah,
an uncontaminated sample.
You're not kidding.
Not really much more I could say about.
What are you going to do?
Celestial advice. I mean, you know, we were expecting it to be a Celestia based episode. This is like kind of a Celestia episode, you know. It's not the Celestia episode people wanted. People wanted her to, we wanted to see more of her backstory, and that's definitely something I think we can look forward to in the future. If this episode is any indication.
It's about 10 of us to every cop. They're gonna wish they'd left with the others.
Yeah. Definitely one of those situations where you can say, yeah, I can see.
How long do we keep her in there? Until we get the order to gas her.
Do your worst.
Where the
boredom is killing me.
Oh, don't worry. You'll get what's coming to you when we're good and ready.
The possibility lies.
Those now. Be my guest.
And,
I'll tell Scarecrow was your
idea. So, Celestial Vice.
What, you think I wanted to know I was going against orders?
Yeah, very. You know, a decent episode. No,
he's done something to his
nothing too special. Like, you know. It's not,
I can't say I'm surprised. You should really respect
unbelievable.
I've seen Freeze with faster
episodes. But it's not a bad episode. It's a good quality episode for what it is. It's a decent opener to the, to season 7. It's definitely...
Something tells me this wasn't part of the
plan. A okay episode. And, the rating. Like I did with episodes last season, I'll be rating it out of 1 to 10. You would remember he did, 1 to
10. Well, that's made things a little more interesting.
Wenny for premiere and for the premiere and the finale last season, but since this is not technically a two-part, I'm going to give each of these their own rating, and I'm treating them as two separate episodes because to me, nothing about it really screamed like a two-part. What there wasn't like a cliffhanger or anything like that, so it was just
charming.
It was what it was. It was not. These were not a two-part. You cannot convince me otherwise. You know, they were, like I said, I used the example of the, Just for Psychic episode. That was what stood out to me. That's the best comparison that I could draw, that these episodes were linked together kind of like that. And so Celestial Vice out of 10 gets a 7.5. It's a very decent episode, and hopefully it's a sign of things to come for Celestia and the show in the future.
Then I burn every plant in Gotham.
Quick drink of water before
what meeting?
Talk about episode 2.
When Two-Face, Riddler, even poor Harley.
Which
that together
was a bit like, Trixie's return in season 6 to me. It wasn't a bad episode. It kind of mixed a bit of the Trixie episode and the one where Starlight accidentally hypnotized the main 6. Minus Twilight. That episode.
Nature.
But yeah, that's pretty much what happened. What I got from the episode. It wasn't a bad episode, which is surprising considering how much I dislike Trixie. But, it really showed a good side of the friendship between Trixie and Starlight,
You only had to ask.
I think the clear message was,
What's wrong?
To forgive and forget, perhaps? I'm not too sure about that. I might be wrong on that. Being the moral, I don't know.
We've got the target, sir. He's cornered.
So, season 7, episode 2. Was noble for it had a lot of feeling, and it had some similarities to episodes from season 6.
Batman, I've spotted 6 more unmanned tanks moving to Chinatown. You'll be there any second.
And what did I think of the episode? I'm gonna give it an okay rating. It wasn't anything special me, you know, but it wasn't anything that I disliked. I think the episode's similarities with episodes from last season were like a bit stupid, if I'm being totally honest. It seemed like, you know, they maybe were running short on ideas. So I'm gonna give episode 2 a 6 out of 10. Like I said, it's not the worst, but you know, it did feel a bit repetitive from season 6. That's just my opinion. Don't jump down my throat. You know.
Activate the Batmobile weapon.
Everyone's free to have their own opinion. My opinion is just that. That was the situation. It was a bit repetitive from what happened. From the stuff that happened in season 6. And, yeah, that's my take on.
Destroy targets to charge up weapon energy and activate missile barrage.
The premiere of.
Missile barrage level 1 ready. Diagnostic stage complete. Stage 2.
Of my old point, season 7, episodes 1 and 2. You'll probably get a review of episode 3, where Twilight will be looking after her favorite niece. As for episode 4, there's a little issue with episode 4, and because I won't have access to this method of recording next weekend, so you'll see a lot of pre-recorded videos. And so episode 4's review won't be up the weekend it should be up. It'll be up the following weekend. It'll probably go up alongside the episode review for episode 5. Of course it'll go before episode 5 because that would make no sense. But I just wanted to let you guys know that will be the situation.
Diagnostic test complete. Simulation complete.
And yeah. Nothing else to be said about that. Really?
I've warned GCP.
Let me know what you think of this style of doing the review.
Come in, all units. This is Commissioner Gordon.
Where you enjoy it, where you didn't enjoy it. Do you think I should do a different game next time?
Is under attack. I want everyone off the streets and back to GCPD. I don't know. We're not equipped to deal with.
Leave your feedback, and I will. I look forward to hearing that. So. Until next time, thanks for watching. I'm George. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. Because I will be reviewing episodes all season long. Until next time, I'll be all. Have a very good day. Peace.